Jay Haynes with the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to talk about creating vertical videos in HitFilm. A vertical video is a video intended for viewing in portrait mode, producing an image that is taller than it is wide. Until recently, vertical videos have been shunned by professional video creators because it does not fit the aspect ratio of established forms such as film, television, and web-based providers such as YouTube. However, the recent rise in popularity of mobile video apps such as Snapchat, TikTok, and Periscope, all of which use the more mobile-friendly portrait format, have led to an increase in the production of vertical videos by content providers as well as advertising companies. A standard high-definition video is 1,920 pixels wide by 1,080 pixels tall. This factors down to an aspect ratio of 16 to 9. If you were to invert these numbers, that would create the dimensions of a typical vertical video. Therefore, when creating content in the vertical video format, you should shoot for a video that is 1,080 pixels wide by 1,920 pixels tall. Here is how you accomplish that in HitFilm. So when you first start HitFilm, you will be presented with the splash screen. You come over and hit the new button and you will be presented with this panel, which is the new project settings. Here's where you'll have your video dimensions right here, as well as a bunch of templates that you can create. Now, if you look at some of these templates, you see, oh, well, here's Instagram portrait. That's got to be pretty close. And it is pretty close. Width of 1080 by 1350. And if you're working with Instagram, that would work great. However, our 1080 by 1920 is what we're looking for. So I'm just going to change this. I need to click off the aspect ratio preservation icon first. Then I can go ahead and make this a 1080 by 1920. You can put the frame rate as to whatever you want, leave everything else the same, and click OK. Then you'll have your correct video ratio here. Now, if you go to File, Project Settings, then you will be able to pull up this exact same thing. And you'll notice that it's considered a custom template, which obviously it is. Okay. But you can go ahead and save this so that you can just pull it up out of your templates. You do that by clicking the Save Settings as a Template button. And you can name it whatever you like, then click OK. Now that is available anytime that you want. You can bring in various footage, and then when you go to drag that footage in, it will say, hey, you want to change this to match the clip? And the answer, of course, will be no, right? Then I can right click and say transform fit to frame height. And now I have this available to be able to scale to wherever I want it to, positioning it as such. Okay. Also, I can do the same with a picture. And again, if I right click and say transform fit to frame height, then it will set it to the exact height that I want it to be at. And everything will look great. If I have filmed a vertical video, then it will obviously fit very nicely into this. Now, how do you go about exporting a vertical video? From here, you will say export, okay, clicking add to queue, and for now, I'll just say contents. And now if you open up the preset, you'll see, oh, this is not going to export as a vertical video. So we will need to create our own preset. So I'm going to click on presets and notice the user presets down here. We're going to create a new preset. And you can make it whatever type of video you want. I will choose an MP4. And let's just go ahead and call this a vertical video. Again, I will want to change the aspect ratio, which means that I will click off dimensions from source, and then it will give me this opportunity, and it will be 1080 across by 1920. Notice that when I do that, of course, it is changing the other one. That's because I have not unclicked the dimensions. So let me unclick that. And that way the dimensions will be there. I will say frame rate from source, or I can change that if I wish. And when I'm all ready, then I can say, okay. So now I have this vertical video preset that I can use whenever I want. I go back to the queue, I open up the drop down menu, and I select vertical video. And now I can go ahead and export that as a vertical video. And that is pretty much exactly how you would do it. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. If you like this kind of content, do me a favor, like this video, subscribe to my channel, click the little bell icon for notification, and as always, thanks for watching.